Hello, welcome to my channel Vet Dandelions, and my name is Billy, and I'm showing you a hammer. And you're saying, why are you showing me a hammer? You're not Nico Cadafcado, you know, being very aggressive with the knife, and you merely being aggressive with the hammer. No, there's a story attached to it. I have tried to attach a darkening, how do you say it? The piece of cloth that you put before the window. We call it gordijn, but I don't know how you call it. I tried to attach the metal rod onto the wall to mount it. And I don't own a screwdriver or a screw machine or whatever. And I tried to do it with a nail and a hammer. I nailed the nail inside the wall. And I thought, one final touch and it's in. Well, the whole rod with the piece of cloth attached to it fell on my head. And I'm saying, well, I had to use a screwdriver and screws, but I thought by myself, I don't own these things, I don't know who owns these things, so I'll do it with or a duct tape or a hammer. So I thought a hammer and some nails will do the job. So I thought, no, wait, there is another thing that I haven't removed from the wall. That's some kind of railing with these things. These. They were side by side onto my window, but because that's kind of old, it's like 20 years old. I live here in this house for 20 years. So it's dirty and it doesn't work that anymore. So I thought maybe to make it prettier and darker with the darkening, I still forget the word for it, gordijnen, we call it. And I put this thing on top of my book cupboard, where I put my books on it. And on top of the book cupboard there, I've put two valises or a luggage, two pieces of luggage on top of it. It's kind of small, it's some kind of kids luggage, but I've put inside some bibs and bobs in it. So I've put the hammer on top of the luggage and I forgot all about it for a whole week. And I said to myself, where did I put it? I can't remember it where I put it. So I think 4 days ago, I found, while I was cleaning up some more boxes and throwing out the boxes, I needed to put the things that I found inside the two luggages. So I grabbed the two luggages on top of the bookcase. And I yanked it down. Something fell on my head. I guess you know what it was. And it fell onto my nugget, on my coconut. And of course, it scared the hell out of me. And I'm gonna show you. You see here, yeah? It used to be more red, and I've washed my head a couple of times, and the stain, the blood stain, is kind of smaller, and it's healed itself. So that's the place where my hammer fell on top of my head. I said to myself, well, I have to sit out this day and don't work up by cleaning loads of boxes and carrying heavy boxes and lifting. So I did it slowly in those 2 days because I had to know if I was gonna be nauseous and headaches and ill, because then I had a concussion and I have to go to the general practitioner, to the doctor's office, to check me out. So I felt like in total 4 days, I haven't been nauseous and sick and having heavy headaches. So I can continue cleaning up. And I'm gonna adjust this. You can see my table is clean. I've cleaned it. I made the lunch. I ate the lunch. I made some soup. And it's my extra large mug with tea. What am I gonna do today? Well, I'm gonna remove this thing. I am so happy because I couldn't find my heavier hammer that I've lost somewhere. I don't know where. That thing was massive and big. If that thing fell on my head, I'd probably be dead. This is a small thing. It's a bit lighter, heavy, but still lighter in comparison with the other hammer that I have that I cannot find. That's why I need to clean up my house. I know I have some items that I've bought and I've used, but I don't know where it is anymore. So I'm gonna take this away. I don't want to see it ever again because this thing fell on my head, on my little coconut. I'm gonna grab something, so I'm gonna stand up. So I received a package 2 weeks ago, and you'll say 2 weeks, you should have shown it earlier. Yeah, 2 weeks I was still cleaning up, you know, and cleaning up and throwing things out, because like I said in earlier videos that I'm a hoarder. So this is the last time I want to be a hoarder. I don't want to deal with this old grief again. So this is what it says. I think it's meant to be careful, breakable, I don't know, burnable. I don't know what it is, but I know what it's inside because I'm gonna do it like this. I received a mail earlier that I think I paid for one ticket or two tickets for the Bankiro Loterij. I played it every month. And I mostly don't win money. I win only cooking books. And I received this mail that I've won something electric and I can choose whatever I want. So they made the list and I could choose from. So you get some beard trimmer, but I'm not a man, so I don't need that. They had a phone, a hair blower. I already have a hair blower and have one hair blower in mind and that I want to buy, and that's not on the list, so I'm not gonna choose from that one. And I found something, so you'll see it's this box in this big box. It's kind of ridiculous why people do that. Yes. So you'll notice it says milk twister, what we call it, milk opschuimer. So you, it's a machine, you put milk inside or special coffee milk, and it warms it up and it twists it. It brings the air inside the milk, so it will be foamy. So when you prepare the cappuccino, you put the milk inside your glass mug, and then you have a real authentic cappuccino, and you'll be a homemade barista. So this is not paid. It's not, I was not paid. I wasn't paid to make an ad for it, but I've won this. I won this gift. So I'm not gonna make a cappuccino today, because I just ate a whole bowl of soup. I'm filled with water, vegetables. So I'm pretty full. And oh gosh. Oopsie. I'm so glad. I wanted to buy this a year ago at bol.com, but I thought by myself, I'm not gonna buy it. I'm such a cheapskate. I'll think by myself, I'm not gonna buy it, because maybe someday when I'll be a famous YouTuber, I can buy it then. But a year later, I've won it. So I'm glad I didn't buy it. I was looking at a video of Bonne Collar. She's a city girl. She lives in the north of Rotterdam. I live in the center of Rotterdam. And she, I think she bought also from bol.com another milk twister. But she said hers were better, but I cannot find hers. Maybe I should watch her. You see? I don't know if you can see it. It's here. You can put the milk inside, and this thing will twist around. You have to attach it here on. Let's see if I can put it. Yes. And then put it in the socket. And then you press on the button, and then your milk will be twisted with air, so it become foamy. So I'm so happy that I've won this. I'm gonna drink real cappuccino. Yes, yes, yes. So happy. So I've won this. Like I said, from the Banchero Lottery, and I have to walk further, because I didn't plan to make this video. So, I think 3.5 weeks ago, I got another email, but Banchero Loterij said, you've won a prize, and you can choose from what prize you want. Do you want cookbooks or magazines? And I got Flow magazine. I picked out the Flow magazine, but it's already, I think, almost a year ago, so that subscription is almost to the end. And I couldn't find the Flow magazine, so I could be for the second year subscribed to it. So that went out of the window. So I didn't pick a magazine. I didn't want to pick a cookbook again, because I've said to myself, I have a whole bookcase with cookbooks, and I've already cleaned two shelves for my private, like one shelf for about China, and another a shelf about feng shui, about horoscope, about other miscellaneous things, mostly about paranormal things. So that was the second bookshelf, and the 1, 2, 3, 4 other bookshelves were about cookbooks. So I said to myself, if one cookbook comes in one cookbook has to go out, either give away or we have some streets further. We have, I can say at the street where my father and mother lives, there's a side street, and in one of those addresses they have some post box, and you can put books in it, and if you like you can grab one book out or a couple of books out and to keep. So if you, I've taken already some books out because I'm cleaning my living room. I've already made a stack of books that I want to put in two post boxes where I can give away my books, because I don't know where to put my books, because I think my books are not worth anymore. So that's the best way to give away. So I've picked this gift by Bankiro Loterij. It's a book about birds. It's still in plastic. You can see. So I picked this book, and this book was a set. And this is beautiful. It says with 80 sounds on CD. So you can hear what kind of sound they make. That's beautiful. And this says a mini Bible about the cages and voliere birds. And I thought voliere birds were also cage birds, but I don't know. It says it isn't. So it has, I think it's the best way to open it. So I hope there are beautiful pictures, because I want to draw and paint and color birds. And I need some inspiration and some examples about birds. So this is the inside. You see how beautiful the pictures are. So I can draw the pictures of the birds. Oh, it says also how you can make the cages and cage rooms. And what they need to eat. Oh, that's smart. How you must take care of them. How to buy birds, how to keep them healthy. So here there are the birds. You see, this here begins. Wait. You see, these are the examples, how colorful the birds are. So I can draw and then paint. I can go also on Google or Pinterest and find birds there to draw them, because they are so beautiful. You can see all the beautiful colors. They say that male birds, are most colorful to attract the female birds, and female birds are dull colored. Because they have the great task to create, make babies, bird babies, and that's why the men are so most colorful birds, and they have to say, hey, look at here, look at me, I am the great example, great thing in the world to procreate and make beautiful bird babies. So I'm happy with this. Let's see how this looks like. So I'm so happy, and I have already deleted 8,000 pictures out of my cell phone, and that's why it's easier now to film this at almost 20 minutes. You see how beautiful those beautiful birds are. And then here on the end, they have the CD. Nice. So this will go inside the bookcase, but I don't know which bookcase, because all my bookcases are full. I need to make space for my birds books collection. So I have found some beautiful birds book in the two poster cases where you can put your books inside if you have no need for the books anymore and you don't want them anymore. I found their beautiful bird books and I've taken it home. So I need a place to put my beautiful bird books. Because all my bookcases are full. It's really ridiculous. I have next to my cookbooks, I have another bookcase with miscellaneous books. And I have to comb out which one I have to keep, which one I have to read. The thing is, I have to read all of them. It's really ridiculous. 6 shelves of books that I have to read. That's really ridiculous. Well, I know for sure I'm not gonna be. I don't have a moment of loneliness. I have a whole case of books that I have to read. So I'm gonna end this video. I wanna thank you for listening and talking about books and gifts that I got from the Bankiro Loterij. And I'm so happy. So, thank you. I've won these. I'm happy. And I want to say bye. See you next time. Bye.